So here today with Oakland County Executive David Coulter, who is running to retain his seat in this election. How are you today?
I'm wonderful, Crystal. How are you?
Great. Thank you for doing this. Can you tell us, how did you become county executive and why have you decided to run again for that?
Yeah. I've been county executive for almost a year now. And I became the county executive after the passing of L. Brooks Patterson, who died last year of pancreatic cancer. And so by state law, an appointment is made until the next election. And so that appointment is made by the Board of Commissioners. And after a lot of political stuff that went on that I was just watching like everybody else, they decided that they wanted to appoint me. And so I was appointed last August. I loved the job, but it was amazing to me how many people said, so what are you going to do next? You know, what are you going to do next year? Are you going to run? What are you going to do? And it was a little overwhelming to me because I didn't expect that. And I said, look, you got to give me some time to see how this is going to go and to see how we do. See if I like it. See if people like me. Mostly what I wanted to get accomplished was I wanted to get a leadership team in place that I thought was really good and strong, and I feel like I've done that. Right away, we had to get the budget done, and I wanted to see how that went, and I'm really proud of the way that went. And so the more I started doing the job, the more I realized that I think I have a good team in place. We're working on some great issues, things that I've been passionate about since I was on the county commission, frankly. As a result, last early November, I decided finally that I would like to stick around and do it for another 4 years.
Now, what are some of those things that you're proud of in this time that you've been on so far?
You know, right away, I mean, so I sort of view life as pre-COVID and after COVID. So, but before all the coronavirus stuff happened, this, you know, we were working on some really good things. We passed the first comprehensive non-discrimination policy in Oakland County history. And that's something that I wanted since I was on the Board of Commissioners. And I was really excited to pass that. We did it at affirmations to show the symbolism that everyone in Oakland County was going to be included and valued and protected. And that's been a big theme of mine. And I was really happy to be able to do that. I mentioned my leadership team. You know, I hired not just a group of really talented professionals, but the most diverse team ever, including the first two women ever to serve in that role as a deputy executive, and the first African American. It's really important to me that we lift up all voices in Oakland County, and diversity being such an incredibly important issue, and obviously that became even more so, but we knew that it was then, and you know, I wanted to embrace that diversity early on. The other thing I'm really proud of is that long before the tragic murder of George Floyd, we had created the new position of Chief Diversity, Equity, and Inclusion Officer in Oakland County. We just hired someone for that position, and we're going to make sure that everything that we do, every policy and every program that we create or run is looked at through this lens of, you know, is it equitable? Is it fair? Does it lift everyone up? So very proud to have created that position. Another thing I'm really proud of is that we launched what we call Oakland Health 360. We have a couple of health clinics in Oakland County that previously had done mostly vaccines and, you know, some limited amount of things like that. But I said, I want, you know, we get tens of thousands of people walking in these doors, and we want to make sure that they have access to a broad array of health services. You know, I'm a huge fan of the Fern Carefree Clinic in Ferndale. I love that model. And so if you've got people coming, what else could we provide them? And so working with the Board of Commissioners, we're going to add primary health care, mental and behavioral health care to our clinics, dental care for our young people, women's health services, which have never happened in Oakland County before. So I'm really proud of the fact that, you know, while Donald Trump and the Republicans are trying to dismantle Obamacare and restrict access to healthcare for our residents, we're actually moving in the opposite direction and trying to expand that. And then finally, I guess I'd say the last thing that really happened before COVID was we went to the rating agencies because Oakland County is very well known for its AAA bond rating, which is, you know, which is a nice external validation of how we do budgeting. And it was my commitment that we would preserve that. We would continue to do budgeting in a good fashion, in a fair fashion, and transparent. And so we went to the rating agencies, and right before Corona, they reaffirmed our AAA bond rating. So, you know, like my time as mayor in Ferndale, I like to believe that you can be a strong, progressive leader and also, you know, fiscally responsible and make sure that you're spending people's money wisely. And so I think, you know, I think we did that. And then, of course, you know, coronavirus sort of took all of our attention.
So one of the things that we are asking all candidates is, how would you be responding to the COVID-19 crisis? You obviously have been at the helm of responding to this. So can you tell us some of the things that you've done to get the county through it?
Yeah. You know, I'd say we took this very seriously and we acted very aggressively. Unlike the president who, you know, had mixed messages and I don't think was very clear when it came to not only the messaging, but the supplying the equipment and that we need, and it was very disappointing, but we knew that we had to lean in because Oakland County, along with Macomb and Wayne, were the three hardest counties hit in the state. We've had over 1,000 people die in Oakland County, over 8,000 get infected. So we have been the epicenter of this. And so broadly speaking, the main thing I did is we leaned in on the science. I listened to the public health experts. And fortunately, we have great experts in Oakland County. And I don't think people realize, but we have 4 epidemiologists on our public health staff. We have a public health officer. We have a medical director. And I met with those folks regularly, and we worked side by side on crafting the best response for Oakland County. And I think we did that. You know, I applaud the governor and the difficult, but I think really important decisions that she made around health orders. But early on, we leaned in even further than her. You know, we were the first county, even before the state, to shut down shopping malls. We required masks and health screenings of our essential businesses even before that was required. We went to 50% occupancy of our restaurants before that was required. We knew that we were in the epicenter here, and we let that science and the public health dictate. The critical thing that must happen now going forward is 2 things, because we're really fighting this on 2 fronts. We're fighting it on a public health front still, because it's not over and we haven't defeated coronavirus, but we're also fighting it on an economic front, and we have to do both of those because people are really hurting and struggling and losing their jobs and their incomes and the like. So on the public health side, testing and tracing is a huge focus for us now. We have 150 people that are doing contact tracing. We're doing drive-through testing at 3 different locations across the county, including in our most vulnerable communities, because one of the things that we unfortunately learned during COVID is that it affects communities of color harder than it does the rest of us. African-Americans are about 14% of the population in Oakland County, but they're about 30% of the positive cases and 36% of the deaths. So we've been really aggressive about getting into communities of color, both with our drive-through testing and most recently partnering with churches in communities like Southfield and Pontiac to make sure that we're reaching those folks and getting them tested. So testing is going to be critical. But on the other hand, on the economic front, we've also been very aggressive about getting money out to our small businesses so that they can keep their employees employed and they can keep their businesses alive. We've done a myriad of things, small business toolkits to make sure they know how to reopen safely. We've given grants out. We've spent almost $60 million fortunately, not of our own money, but of the federal CARES dollars, to make sure that our businesses, our nonprofits, and our faith-based communities all have the resources that they need. You know, and I stress that because part of my goal also is that no one gets left behind. It's not just about saving businesses. It's about our nonprofit organizations. It's about our faith base. It's about our homeless population. One of the things I'm most proud of that we did is what we call our food to shelter program. We reached out to the organizations that are working with our homeless population. We made sure they had a good, safe place to stay where they could social distance, but we also linked them to restaurants because they primarily got food from smaller churches who were not operating anymore. And so food was a big issue for them. So we got them hooked up with restaurants that were also struggling to make sure that that population was fed. So, just, you know, overall, making sure that no one is left behind and that we do whatever we can, you know, to protect the residents of Oakland County.
So can you tell us, you mentioned having been mayor of Ferndale, what is some of your other experience that you bring to the table for this?
You know, I learned a lot being mayor of Ferndale. I thought that would be the best political job I ever had in my life, and then I got here. But I learned a lot, and I certainly took some of those things with me. Obviously, you know that Ferndale values diversity, not just for the sake of a slogan, but it was really part of the way that we became successful in Ferndale is to make sure that everyone felt welcome and invited to participate in Ferndale. I think that's, you know, one of the secret sauces of Ferndale. And we were a welcoming city. Now, I'm proud to say, Oakland County is a welcoming county. And I think that's important, especially for people who are foreign born. We have a very large and diverse immigrant and refugee population in Oakland County, and I don't think we've done enough over the years to sort of lift them up and celebrate them, and most importantly, give them a seat at the table. And so that's certainly something that I bring with me from Ferndale. The other thing is, you know, I was a what they call a climate change mayor when I was in Ferndale. We were the first city in Oakland County to hire a full-time sustainability planner to really help us craft a strategy for how we could protect the environment, reduce our footprint, our carbon footprint in Ferndale. And we took very concrete actions. And so my plan is to hire a sustainability planner in Oakland County to make sure that Oakland County, which has an even greater impact on the environment and on the economy, takes the lead and is truly a green county and moves boldly on those initiatives. So that's something that certainly I took from Ferndale. And maybe the last thing that I would say is, you know, around this issue of, you know, the racial demonstrations that we're seeing and the racial inequalities that are once again being exposed in this country, you know, we weren't immune from that in Ferndale. You know, just because we were Ferndale doesn't mean that we didn't have racial perceptions and racial issues in our community and with our law enforcement. But I'm proud of the fact that, you know, although we're not perfect and we didn't get everything perfectly right, we didn't shy away from the issue. And so, you know, we took, I think, really proactive steps to adopt community policing as a formal guidelines for us in Ferndale. We were the first city that did body cams, which is one of the recommendations of the community guidelines, community policing guidelines. We really had a zero tolerance as a council for any sort of police abuse power. And I'm proud of that because I didn't realize that's not always the case. We actually had an outside independent investigation of the policies and procedures of our police department so that we could better understand where we were in terms of best practices. So, like I said, there was no silver bullet. It's tough work and it requires, you know, a lot of effort and cooperation, but, you know, I'm really proud of the fact that we didn't shy away from that work, and it still needs to continue both in Ferndale and across the country and across Oakland County. And I hope to be part of that conversation in Oakland County as well.
You are elected to stay in this position. What are some of the things that you want to work on?
Yeah. So I want to fully implement our Oakland Health 360. It's a three-year project, and so we've made a $4 million commitment to doing it, but we have to implement it, so I certainly want to do that. There's another project that I'm really excited about, and we're calling it Oakland 80, and that is, at the state level, the governor unveiled a program called 60 by 30, and that is that 60% of our residents would have some sort of a post-secondary degree or certification by 2030. It's really important that we get our residents the skills that they need so that they are an educated workforce that can be successful. So we looked at that in Oakland County, and we found out that we're already pretty close to 60% of our adults in Oakland County have post-secondary degree or certification. So we brought the education community together, people from Oakland University and Lawrence Tech and OCC and our labor partners, because, you know, getting like a skilled trade certification would be ideal and wonderful and helpful to having a great career. And so we set the ambitious goal that we want to get to 80% in Oakland County. So that's something I very much want to do. And then maybe I would also mention, it goes without saying for those people who know me, but if they're just getting to know me, I'm a huge transit advocate. I always have been. We worked on that very hard before COVID. I was disappointed that we didn't get a plan on the ballot in November. The legislature sort of screwed up our plans there, but I'll never give up on that. I believe that there's almost no single project that we could do together as a region that would improve the quality of life, help us attract and retain our younger people, and help our employers and employees both, than to get some sort of a transit plan in Oakland County and the Southeast Michigan region. And so I continue to be 100% committed to that as well.
So in this race, you do have some competition both in the primary and in November. Why should the voters pick you?
You know, I hope they see that I'm somebody that doesn't just talk the talk, but actually gets things done. I tend to be sort of not as flashy, or maybe not as loud, or I don't tend to scream and all of those things. I'm really focused on results. I'm not so much about slogans. So, for instance, like in Ferndale, when I said I want to be a climate change mayor, you could have just left it there, you know, but no, I wanted to make sure that we were actually creating policies and procedures and positions that supported real results. And so what I always ask people is that, you know, look at not just what I said I want to do, but what I've actually done. Look at the results, look at the diverse team that I've hired, you know, look at the health changes that we're making. Look at the way we let science guide us through the coronavirus and help bring down the numbers in Oakland County. And I'm convinced that science-based approach actually saved lives in Oakland County, and I'm proud of that. So you know, what I would say is, don't, you know, you can listen to, we all have our ideas and we all have our slogans or whatnot, but I think that if they listen to the things I actually do, they'll see that I get results, and they'll see that I do that because my general leadership style is to be collaborative. I really believe in bringing all voices to the table, trying to, you know, I'm not afraid to make a decision, but I like them to be very well-informed decisions, and I like to hear from as many perspectives as I can, Republicans, Independents, and Democrats alike. You know, no political party has a monopoly on good ideas, and I like to hear them all, and then try to craft solutions that make sense for people. And so, I think that's what differentiates me from the other candidates in this race.
So if the voters want more information about you and your campaign, where can they go?
Yeah, so I have a very active Facebook page, and they can go there, just, you know, David Coulter. I also have a website, davecoulter.com, which has lots more information about the things that I believe in and how to get involved in the campaign and those sort of things. So those are probably the two best ways.
Great. Well, thank you so much for doing this interview today.
Crystal, it's always my pleasure. Thank you so much for having me.